In Gilroy, schools there are facing their own money troubles, but what makes them a little bit different is they are saving millions without cutting teachers. How are they doing it? Here's Action News reporter Felix Cortez live in Gilroy to tell us.
Well, like any other school district, Aaron, the Gilroy Unified School District does have its budget problems, a $2.5 million budget gap it has to close over the next 2 years. But despite that, teachers won't have to worry about getting pink slips this year.
There was a standing ovation in the room when she said that, and you could just kind of feel it.
A promise from the superintendent of the Gilroy Unified School District that no pink slips will be handed out this year.
Better on the students if they don't cut teachers, because you spend all year getting used to one teacher and then they disappear.
And if they laid off any more teachers, the class sizes would just keep growing and growing, and it's really nice that they're keeping the teachers to keep the classes, like, slightly not as full.
Like most school districts around the state, Gilroy Unified has budget problems, but Superintendent Deborah Flores says cuts will be made as far away as possible from the classroom, including special programs and sports.
Like, for me, if it weren't for sports, I'd be actually probably out of shape. Right now, I'm actually in pretty good shape.
Like auto and culinary and arts and all these programs, if they can stay, there's lots and lots of students that need this kind of program for their future. So I'm just ecstatic that they're not going to make any cuts.
The superintendent says cuts will be made at the district office. As many as three people could lose their job. A vacant assistant superintendent position will be eliminated, another downgraded. And early retirement incentives will be offered to 15 teachers. Already, thousands of teachers around the state have received pink slips. Gilroy teachers relieved they're not among them.
We're feeling dog-eared here lately, and so it's nice to, at least at this school, that the newer instructors are allowed to perfect their craft.
Well, we talked about some of the cuts that the district wants to make. Well, the district also wants to raise revenues, and one way they're talking about doing that is charging some students $1 to ride the bus. That plan will go before the school board when it meets next week. Aaron, Dan.
All right, Felix. Thanks.